So this is day one, and it's been about 6 hours on this 22-hour bus ride from Buenos Aires up to Jujuy. I figured I'd get the video in before the sun set, so you guys could see something that's in my face. I thought it would be a pretty uneventful day, because we'd be on a bus the entire day, but it turned out to be rather eventful, starting with this kind of wild, crazy woman that would not stop talking to us at the bus station. And then, moving on to a guy on the bus that seemed to be drunk and his mouth full of coca leaves. Eventually, the National Guard came on the bus and had to get off and empty out all of his beer. So I don't know what's going on there, but it made me think that perhaps as Laura and I left, Buenos Aires, our expat card was revoked, so we were no longer expats with that little bit of the benefit that now we were full-fledged American tourists. We're gonna get scrutinized and heckled by any weirdo that we came along. And so, that got me thinking about the fact that I think a lot of people are generally scared of people that they meet, strangers that they meet. And it's kind of saddening, because if someone comes up to you, anybody really in the city, your first reaction is probably going to be, you know, what does this person want? Do they want money? Are they trying to get me to help them? Rarely do you just meet somebody, I guess, and it's a friendly relationship. We couldn't tell if the old lady at the bus station wanted money. She seemed to want to read to us some dissertation she had written about hope or something. I think the coca leaf guy did want to be our friends, but I was tired as a little get out. Did not want to talk to anybody at the time. Another thing I thought would be worth mentioning in this video is, it's interesting noticing as we were leaving Buenos Aires that you can see, actually you can see now in the background we're coming across in a bit of an industrial plant. And it just, that's all it's been, just slowly, less and less factories and industrial plants and shipping container trucks and gas container trucks and smog and soot coming less and less as we get back, you know, back into the large sort of natural lands of northwestern Argentina. And because I started this trip coming off of a bit of a stomach virus, I started to draw the connection, like, from the Matrix, that maybe as human beings we are sort of acting as a virus or a parasite on this single living creature that is Earth. And if you look around, you start to see evidence of that. When you think, you change your perspective, you see that we're kind of doing our own thing, constantly hauling around fuels, materials, driving these cars, and everything else is pushed to the side. All the natural environment is pushed to the side. I mean, it's disgusting how much trash I've seen just accumulate. I mean, you can even see it in the background of this picture. There's a plastic bag there. There's a couple bottles there, just in the little gullies, just bottles and shoes and all sorts of garbage. And it's just disgusting. And I remember from the last video where we were on the map looking at the city sprawled out, Buenos Aires, that we were leaving from. And I guess you could look at it in a really high, mighty light as some beautiful creation of humanity, but it also could be looked at as just kind of a sprawling sore on the earth that we're kind of sucking all the goodness out of until it will fundamentally die to us. You know, like a rabbit might get eaten by a bacteria virus, it dies, and it gets attacked by different parasites, fungus, and bacteria, and it's a whole different thing. guess, dark thoughts on the first day, because it's been a lot of bus riding, a lot of thinking. But excited to get farther and farther away from the city now. I will talk to everybody tomorrow.